The battle of Titan versus Titan. The struggle of good versus evil versus a folding chair. It's a new day in the cesspool, and we're talking about wrestling games. Okay, now it may surprise you to learn, get ready, I'm not much of an athlete in real life, which is why I prefer to experience wrestling athletics in video game form. But which wrestling game is the greatest show of shows? Okay, I actually have no idea, but aha, I had one idea, which is why I have WWE superstar and G4 host Xavier Woods, a.k.a. Austin Green. Whoa!
What up, Sessler?
Okay, so obviously, as you being a wrestler, intros are kind of important. Does that, what you just did, qualify as an intro? And was that designed specifically for me? And how should I feel about that?
100%. You should feel honored, very happy. I made sure that was for you specifically. You're an entertainer yourself, so I assume you've got some sort of entrance too, right?
I had a feeling this was going to come up. So I actually recorded one earlier. I can only do so many in the course of a day. Some people might claim it's derivative. But just to reiterate, you know, it was done earlier in the day. Here we go. And I know this is, once again, going to come to a shock to a lot of people. You have an intense passion for wrestling games.
I do. Yeah. I love wrestling and I love video games, so it's the perfect fit.
What do you look for in a game that really makes it connect with you?
I want the game to be as fun as humanly possible. That's the point of video games to me, case in point. Like, that's the bottom line, is this fun, regardless of what it looks like. So for me, I like for them to have, like, good mechanics. It doesn't have to feel like I'm actually wrestling. I don't need it to be like realistic and all that stuff. As long as I can, you know, throw somebody over the ropes and dive out onto them, and I can dress my guy how I want, because create a wrestler is beyond important to me.
All right, Austin. Today we are going to crown the greatest wrestling game of all time. So I'm going to defer to you. Where should we start?
We got to go back a little bit, because there's been so many good games. I don't think we got to go back way, way, way back. But at least to like Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis. So I feel like we're doing all right if we start at a game called Saturday Night Slam Masters. Saturday Night Slam Masters was incredible. One reason, because they had these entrances where you have the flashing lights, you've got like fog, there's people screaming and all that stuff. But it was more of like an arcade fighter, but just set kind of in a wrestling ring. It's got Haggard from Final Fight in it. So it's kind of that Final Fight battle system with a couple extra things, like being able to jump off the ropes and pin people, obviously, putting them in like submission holds. But if you like side-scrolling beat 'em ups and wrestling, like, this is literally the perfect game. This I would count just more as like a fun game, and you're kind of using wrestling as the conduit, as opposed to like some of the other wrestling games that were coming out a little bit later than this.
I think our next stop is a world tour, and that is WCW NWO World Tour.
Ah, yes. Jumping into the first of the N64 classics. Now, people that are watching this, they go, best wrestling game of all time, which one are they gonna pick? That person has clearly played this game. They've played all the N64 wrestling games. World Tour was the jam. I think it was the first in the line of N64 wrestling games of this format.
I have a very clear memory of producing the review of this game. And knowing that this had become quite a big deal. Compared to what we just looked at with Saturday Night Slam Masters, this really looks like a wrestling game. You know, it's just crude as it might be because it's the N64. You can see how the other one was kind of like slow Street Fighter, and this has that grapply feeling you would expect from a wrestling game.
So there's weak grapples, strong grapples, and so each of the grapples has X amount of moves that you can attach to it. So it felt different from a game like Slam Masters, where you have like your buttons for like punch and kick and grab, and your guy might have one or two moves. In this, you have what I think like 16 moves, and you can customize them with your creator wrestler. And so it just felt better, and it felt like you were watching wrestling and controlling it. And so this game changed my life. I'll just say it.
Let's move on to the next entry in the WCW NWO series, and that is Revenge. From 98.
This game has quite possibly the greatest intro of any game.
I can hear, like, the excitement is intense. This is just the intro to the sequel? to World Tour? You know,
yeah.
Revenge.
This is.
Why do you look like you're about to jump out of your skin?
Because I love this so much. Like, this is what you see is genuine happiness. This intro is like, it feels like it's like 9 minutes long for no reason at all. Trucker doesn't know what's going on. Why are these barrels on fire? Why is Sting in the middle of the road with no lights on the street?
If I was in the truck, there's a pretty good solution to the problem at hand. It's the truck. Just hit the gas.
But see, yeah, now they go into like the full intros and they're showing all the guys and their factions. At this point, there's white, black and white NWO, there's black and red NWO, and they show them together. And it's like, oh, there's signs now. Like, the game is clearly upgraded.
Yeah, it's huge jump in production value, even though only a year has elapsed.
I feel like that really solidified these N64 wrestling games was this game. This is the one where they go, this is what wrestling games are now. All of them will be like this. And here's the first one.
Let's move on to WWF No Mercy from the year 2000.
This game, my word. This was the first WWE game in these series. And it's something that the WWE fans have been waiting for so long, because we got to play with the WCW characters and they have like, what, like 60 or 50 characters in their game or wrestlers in their game. But the fact that we now have the WWE version, it changes everything.
This game coming out was kind of, yeah, it was this convergence of what everybody wanted. You know, it was the characters they wanted with the sort of engine and controls that people were in love with. And we're 2 years from Revenge, but this looks like sort of improvements both aesthetically and just the frame and the speed that they're playing. Like, this doesn't look like 2 years worth of work. This looks like far more significant. This is one of the better looking N64 games. It really is quite impressive. All right, let's move forward into the year 2002 with WWE SmackDown Shut Your Mouth.
At this point, I'm already like, I'm going to be a pro wrestler, because this is 2002. So I'm a sophomore in high school. I'm on the wrestling team, and it luckily worked out.
I think the other very important thing to note about Shut Your Mouth, we're now moving out of the N64 era, and now we're on the PlayStation 2. And wow, I mean, we're once again talking about a very, very significant jump, both graphically and, I mean, it's moving faster, it's moving smoother. I mean, just look at this frame rate.
Definitely. I believe in this one, they had Ric Flair and Vince McMahon were in charge of each of the shows, and they had like rival storylines, and you'd work on one show, go interfere with the other one. And so that was kind of cool.
Now, speaking of having an effect, here is a game I played a lot of. From the moment I heard it sort of announced as a concept, I was so into it, it's ridiculous. And this is Def Jam Vendetta from 2003. This is my semi coming down a road. It gets me excited.
I think that this is a fantastic one, because it took a bunch of Def Jam rappers, Def Jam artists, and gave them these Aki mechanics. And that's when you realize, like, yes, the fact that it had like the WWE for WCW skin on everything, yeah, because those are things that we're familiar with, but it's this game system, it's this engine that's good. Mm-hmm. You put whatever you want on it and keep the engine there, like, you're gonna play it. And that goes back to my point of earlier, of the whole point of any game for me is it's gotta be fun. These games inspired an entire new audience to come to these wrestling games because of how good it is.
All right, so moving on. Actually, this is in the same year, so this should be an interesting contrast. WWE SmackDown, Here Comes the Pain. Big Show. I remember interviewing him. This man could palm my head.
Oh, yeah. He's like three heads taller than me, and his hands are just, like you said, the size of people's heads.
A lot of wrestlers could appear on screen all at once.
So many.
This was not feasible back on even the N64 or something like that. And they're there. It looks good.
The fact that it was six people to play at once, it was so smooth. So now you can have those two people who used to sit on the sidelines and you'd pass the controllers to when two people lost. Now they can play as well. And now you're all screaming at the top of your lungs while utter chaos is occurring, which to me, these wrestling games are built for multiplayer play.
Austin, you played WWE SmackDown versus Raw 2006 on your show Up, Up, Down, Down all the time, so this is one of the least surprising games to be found on this list. What is it that just stands out to you?
the fact that there's so many new things to the franchise. So the most important one for myself being general manager mode. So that's what we do on the channel. So general manager mode is you're either in charge of Raw or SmackDown. You draft your rosters, then you build your show. You pick five matches, whether you want them to be regular matches, a Hell in a Cell, a First Blood match, a hardcore match, a backstage barroom brawl. You've got all of these different options for that. And it's kind of like the first time we get the chance to have a simulated wrestling show. Probably the biggest thing with this is when it first came out, I was big on the PSP. I loved it. It was amazing. And this game, this is the first wrestling game, you could also get it on PSP and keep your season mode going. So instead of being finished when I'm done with the console, I would download my data from my PS2 and then be in the car in the backseat when my parents were driving, continuing my season on my PSP. And so you literally never had to stop playing this game.
Let's move quite a bit forward into recent history. Uh-oh. And this is Fire Pro Wrestling World. Mm-hmm. It came out a few years ago, although... Looking at it, a lot of people might not think that. So I have to ask you, it's from 2017. Why did it make it to this list?
Because they have taken the time to take the 2D format and make it look as crisp as possible. And by doing mm-hmm. that, they've then allowed themselves so much more space to create other things. So I think this game has the most moves of any wrestling game ever. So when you make your creator wrestler, you've got so many incredible options.
This is like the old game doing everything you imagined it was supposed to do back then.
It takes that old school look, but gives you all of the assets and the modes from the newer games. So it's got, like you said, that nostalgic feel, but it's just so well done to the point where you can't really deny that this is a quality game.
All right. I personally feel like I've lived a lifetime through your eyes with all of these wrestling games. There's no question that you have affection for everything we looked at, but you know there can only be one. Which one are you crowning as the best wrestling game of all time?
All right. I'm going to have to say the greatest wrestling game of all time as of right now is...
Fire Pro Wrestling!
The most recent on our list.
It is.
I'm not going to question you, because if I did, you'd probably snap me over your thigh like a twig. But no. If you wouldn't mind saying why this rises like the cream over just the milk.
Well, because the cream else on the list. Rises to the top. Yeah. So this game won out for me because everything that we've talked about on why all of the games on this list are so good, this game has every single one of them. It's got the crazy creator wrestler. It's got the general manager mode. It's got like the most moves of any wrestling game. It's crisp 2D in a 3D space with the cameras moving as well. All of the things and all of the reasons all these other games are good, they've wrapped it up into one game and given it to us. So that's why I say, for right now, because we don't know what's coming in the future, and we don't know if somebody's gonna make some sweet mod for games in the past, Fire Pro Wrestling World is today's victor.
So Austin, we don't know if this is a good idea or not, but we haven't been sued. Just like to impart some wisdom about what we've learned today. Would you care to join me in that?
Oh, well, of course. I used to work at a school and the gifted kids used to call me Professor Xavier, so yeah. We'll go ahead and do that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's funny. I think I've heard of another guy who had that. Yeah, he had
maybe
that.
One or two.
Tip number 7. There is a difference between a strong grapple and a weak grapple, but both would hurt me.
Number 6. Big Show can palm Sessler's head.
Number 5. At least one person really, really loved the PSP.
Number 4. An amazing intro is essential to wrestling.
Number 3, wrestling is just anime with spandex.
Number 2, that No Mercy menu song.
And finally, number 1, stopping a semi-truck with flaming barrels is the coolest thing you can do.
Perfect.
All right, everyone, check out the G4 Discord. Please give us feedback, not just on this video, on all the other videos. I know this sounds incredibly corporate and hollow. We actually do care what you think. And on that note, the exact opposite of corporate and hollow, Austin, thank you so much for joining me today. I can honestly say there's no way I could have done even an iota of this without you.
Oh, get out of here. You know a ton of stuff. But I honestly just can't wait until we actually are in the G4 studio and we can actually hang out in the same physical space.
Really? Human interaction?
Yeah.
It's so warm and without people here, I feel the safest I've ever been.
Sessler, you know what? I'm going to see you out in the ring. You can do it. It's going to be great.
All right. I'll do it for you. I'll wear shorts.
I got shorts on right now. Instagram style.
Really?
Bam. Blue ones.
Yeah, but yeah, but you also have legs that are worth showing. Chickens laugh when I walk past them.
Muck, 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 muck.